lighten you about November 4th and 5th. I will be out of the studios. I'll be racing at Sebring, a great Chin track day over at Sebring on November 4th and 5th. Also, sometime in the middle of November, end of November, we're going to have our big fall festival at the Lange Institute. So I'm letting y'all know. Remember, that's when we usually have huge sales on all the Fortify products. We usually have a specific dress code. You know, it was the 60s. It was the 50s. It was the 70s. Hell, this might be, I don't know, it might be a Western. I don't know yet, but I'll let everybody know. All right. If you're new to the program, who's Dr. Lange? Well, I'm a board-certified optometric physician. I'm also a certified nutritional specialist. I founded Lange Eye Care and Associates March 15th of 1993. We opened 13 locations in the state of Florida, and then last year in April, I ended up selling all of them except the Lange Eye Institute. And yes, hard work does pay off. If you really work hard and you work 18, 19 hours a day, 7 days a week for 20-some-odd years, it does pay off. So if you want to see me or any of the doctors at the Lange Eye Institute takes care of just about every aspect of eye care and cosmetic surgery as well. We have Dr. Michael Tolentino, the retina specialist on board, Dr. Seaborn Hunt, an amazing cataract surgeon, Dr. Yadi Exposito, an incredible optometric physician, of course, myself, Dr. Michael Lange, and then Michael Moore, Hear More Medical Center is in there. John Podlatsky, with his naturopathic abilities, I should say, if you want to see someone into homeopathic, natural, as natural healthcare as possible, Dr. John Podlatsky has his wellness institute upstairs. We have dentistry, we have podiatry, all at the Lange Eye Institute, all under one roof and a lot more. All right, we're going to go to the first call of the morning. And then we have a very welcome guest with us today I'm going to introduce. But first, we're going to see. Oh, it's amazing. Steve actually beat Bob once again. Steve in Bradenton, good morning.
Good morning, Doc. How you doing?
I'm all right. How you doing today?
Well, I don't know. My vision's getting a little blurry, and I was just wondering, when you hear the term diabetic retinopathy, does that mean swelling in the retina, or is there other factors involved?
Right. Diabetic retinopathy comes in a lot of different flavors, Steve. I mean, basically, you have what we used to call background diabetic retinopathy or non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, and that's when you have these leaky microaneurysms, so small dot and blot hemorrhages all over the retina. And then we go to what we call proliferative diabetic retinopathy. That's where you have these little leaky blood vessels that actually have what we call neovascularization associated with them. This means little blood vessels that grow under your retina and into the retina, and they leak profusely, and that can lead to swelling of the retina or diabetic maculopathy, or the medical term is clinically significant macular edema related to diabetes. And so, you know, many patients, we deal with this all day long at the Lange Eye Institute, and the whole key here, and you are aware of this because the main thing you did was get your blood sugar under control, you know, naturally, and also following your medical doctor's advice, losing the weight, you know, watching your diet. We have to get our blood sugar down to the ideal levels, hemoglobin A1C, fasting blood sugars, all of that. And then in theory, the body starts to heal itself. The bleeding starts to get minimized. These irregular blood vessels go away. But in a nutshell, you have to see a retina specialist because they have to do all sorts of treatments, as you're aware of. They can do laser treatments. They can do injectable treatments, injections of anti-VEGF drugs, injections of steroids. But you have to be able to help your doctor by controlling that blood sugar. And quite frankly, in America, the typical diet of most Americans is a pro-inflammatory, calorie-dense, nutrient-deficient diet. And people are getting fatter and fatter and fatter, and this diabetes is on a rampage. So patients have to really take the bull by the horns, and they have to be proactive in their health by watching their diet and losing weight, getting down to their ideal body weight. And, you know, I'm preaching to the choir because you've been listening to this for a long time, Steve, and you've been doing what we've been talking about. And yet you have had some problems, but a lot of those problems may be associated with when you were heavier and your blood sugar wasn't as controlled as well.
And then later on in life, I guess, it pops up, right?
Right. We're more prone to get this as we age. Absolutely. But it can affect anybody at any age. Just like glaucoma, a lot of people think glaucoma can't affect anybody but the elderly. But I have many children that have glaucoma. So diabetes and diabetic retinopathy can affect anybody at any age. But yes, we are more prone to get it as we get older.
Now, what kind of symptoms do you get when you get that diabetic retinopathy? Things just get blurry. Is that it?
Right. Foggy vision. With diabetes, oftentimes you have a myopic shift in your vision. That means you get more nearsighted, so things get blurry in the distance, okay? Obviously, if you have swelling of the macula, you're going to start to get a distortion of your vision. So your central acuity, your color vision can be off a little bit, your sharpness, your contrast sensitivity. When you're reading letters, all of that can be blurry, and sometimes actually it can be missing. You can have a blind spot in the center of your vision, just depending on how bad the diabetic maculopathy actually is.
Can a person live a normal life with this situation, or does this get worse and worse to the point where you're blind?
Well, no. I have many patients I've been following for 30 years that have never gone blind from it. All right. So I have many patients that have never gone blind from it. By the same token, I do have patients that do go blind from it. And, you know, like I said, you have to do what you're doing, and you have been doing that. You know, we've been talking for years now, and you've been doing the things necessary to get the job done, so to speak. You got two great eye doctors. You know, you're following your diet. You're doing everything, you know, everything possible. And then, you know, it's in the good Lord's hands.
It's just a little frustrating when things are blurry. The last few days, things seem like they've been blurrier than they have been, which I don't know if they are or if it's all in my mind. You know, I was in there a week and a half ago, and he gave me the injection in the arm so he could look in my eyes. It's like an iridescent coloration of some sort. And he said the circulation was great. The optic nerve was great. He says your swelling is down from 568 down to 510, which I didn't know what that meant, but he said that was significant. And I've been looking forward to better vision, and it's just not getting there. And I just wondered if it's finally to the point where it's just going to go south and that's the end of it.
Well, that was a fluorescein angiogram that you had, and that looks for leakage in the retina. It sounds like it was relatively good, so that's a very good sign. That's very good to have a good fluorescein angiogram. And you got to keep the faith, Steve. You got to keep the faith. Don't give up hope. You know, keep doing what you're doing, and you know, the strong prevail. Hopefully you're going to maintain where you're at or regain some of that vision. And remember, you're young enough. I mean, I think you're in your 60s. You're young enough where we're going to find ways via microchips, you know, bionic eyes, things of this nature that they're using now, and we're going to regain some valuable vision in your life. We'll be talking about taking people out of the darkness on this show, and I hopefully very soon.
Okay. So they just put a microchip in, they don't have to replace your whole eye?
That's exactly right. They're using microchips right now, and this microchip technology is going to get better and better and better, and your vision is going to get better and better and better. So you just got to hang in there.
All right. Thank you, doctor. I sure appreciate you being there.
All right. Steve, you take care of yourself, buddy.
Take care, brother. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
He's been a good caller for many years, and he's very rare, Steve, in front of Bob as a caller. Anyway, the phone lines are open, 1-866-977-4820, 1-866-977-4820. I do want to take this opportunity. A very welcome guest has been sitting across from me quietly and patiently. I'm just going to introduce him, and then we're going to talk more in a few minutes, but Franz Leasing. Franz, I want to welcome you to Ask the Doctor.
Thank you, Michael Lang.
And so Franz is a friend of mine. He's also a workout partner of mine, and he's vice president of a up and coming company called HyperUp, which is a marketing machine that utilizes social media. And we're real excited to have him on the show. We'll talk a little bit about that because we do have a lot of listeners that have small businesses, medium businesses, and also CEOs of some super large businesses that listen to Ask the Doctor. So, Franz, we're going to get back to you in a minute. Thanks for being a guest on the show.
Sounds good. Thank you.
All right. 1-866-977-4820. 1-866-977-4820. Pick up the phones. Give me a call. Let's go back to Bob. Bob, Steve beat you this morning, buddy.
I want to put that into contention. That's all right. Fine. I enjoyed listening to Steve, and he brings his personal questions to the table, and that's generally far more important than what I have to say. Dr. Lang, I'm going to go back a number of years, pretty much when I first was introduced to your program with the Omega-3 Styrofoam Cup challenge. Mm-hmm. That was a significant thing for me. It doesn't sound like much, but it was trying that with the Omega-3 that I was taking currently and burned a hole in the bottom of that Styrofoam Cup and made a mess of my kitchen countertop in about 15 seconds. And I had been a devout listener and consumer of your Super Omega-3. But along the lines, you know, I've talked with quite a few people about their consumption of Omega-3. And, you know, a lot of people say, well, I'm taking it from ABC and wherever, wherever. And it's, quote, standard strength. And I encourage them to try the Styrofoam Cup test. But because it is so weak, it doesn't burn the cup, and they're left with the false impression that their over-the-counter omega-3 is a good thing. Now, said all that to say this. If it's a third of the strength of a super fortified omega-3, would three of their over-the-counter capsules burn the cup?
No. Yeah, that's a great question, Bob. And typically, the over-the-counter preparations, we call 18-12 or 18-20, actually, depending on the potency. And so most of these over-the-counter preparations of omega-3 that you buy have 180 EPA and 120 DHA. And that's relatively low. And then it's in the ethyl ester molecule. Remember, ethyl ester molecule is a very inexpensive way to manufacture omega-3. It causes it to be very unstable and not very bioavailable, causes you to burp back a nasty fish taste. And the ethyl ester molecule, remember, has ethanol attached to the backbone. It's a very inefficient step because you consume that. It has to go through your liver, cleave off the ethanol, replace a triglyceride backbone before it absorbs into the body. So that's very inefficient. It causes absorption to be very poor. It's a very unstable molecule, so it goes rancid very quickly, and it stinks. So that's why I developed Fortify Super Omega in the triglyceride molecule, so it absorbs right into the bloodstream, doesn't pass through the liver. It isn't unstable, doesn't go rancid quickly at all. So, yes, you could actually take that whole bottle, and since the concentration is so weak, it's never going to eat a hole. Well, I wouldn't say never. I mean, after days, it might rot a hole through that cup. But it's not going to do it initially. So it's got to be higher in concentration than the 180, 120. And there are, not to mention any names due to legal ramifications, but you can go over the counter to the box stores, and they usually have two brands. They'll have the 180, 120, and then they'll have their super potent, same exact brand, which is more like, you know, 560, 420 or something like that. That one will rot right through that Styrofoam cup. Now, folks, you have to bite the end of it off or snip the end of it off, squeeze it into the Styrofoam cup, and you'll see what happens. You'll see how it dissolves that Styrofoam cup. And then chemists will always say, well, that's like dissolves like blah, 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 and this is the reason for that. But all that does is demonstrate that is the ethyl ester molecule. Now, it's not got enough ethanol to really hurt you. However, you never know. Your great-grandmother that has liver problems, you know, pregnant and nursing women, you don't want to take the chance with that kind of stuff. So as a rule of thumb, you want to be as healthy as possible. You want to practice good health techniques. So you take a triglyceride form. The sad thing is, in America, 98% of all fish oil you buy over the counter is ethyl ester molecule. In Europe, it's just the opposite. You go to Copenhagen in Denmark or Norway, Sweden, it is illegal for them to sell the ethyl ester molecule. You can't buy it. You can only buy the triglyceride form. And I always recommend, if you just don't know and you don't want to go to Amazon and buy Fortify Super Omega, you don't want to come to the Lange Institute, Fortify Vitamins and Ocala. You don't want to go to the fortify.com website or get it through, you know, hundreds and hundreds of medical professionals throughout the state and throughout the country that are selling it. Then I always say, get the liquid form, all right? Because most liquid forms they sell over the counter are triglyceride form. Most are. Make sure it's in a glass bottle and it's only a 1 month supply, because the liquid form has to be refrigerated. If it's older than a month, it starts to go rancid.
All right. Okay. Well, I was kind of hoping that three of the cheaper ones was going to prove the point, but if not,
nope.
So be it.
Won't work.
That's okay, fine. Let me take just a brief moment and toot my own horn here, Dr. Lange. My wife and I celebrated 50 years yesterday.
Congratulations. But, you know, I don't endorse people getting married at 12, okay?
I appreciate that.
Bob.
Well, there you are, brother. I'll be 71 next Friday.
You don't look a day over 60. Take care of yourself.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, brother. Bye-bye.
All right. You're listening to Ask the Doctor and my very welcome guest, Franz Lysing, Vice President of HyperUp. I got to tell you, folks, you got to go to Google and Google HyperUp. It is really pretty cool. You got to look at an animated little guy they got called Hype. You guys worked on him for a long time. It's like the Geico, the little lizard on Geico. You got your own little guy called Hype now, don't you?
Yeah, he's been a long project now, and it's been about 2 months since we've been working on him, and he's coming alive, and he's there kicking it, and you're going to see a lot of him coming around the Tampa area and all over the U.S., so internationally eventually, so just keep an eye out.
Right, and so their website is hyperup.com, right?
Yes.
And you're going to officially launch... When?
Next month.
Next month.
Yes.
And can people go there and actually sign up so they can be one of the first on this marketing machine?
Yeah, you can go today on www.hyperup.com and sign up as a consumer and get deals and or as a business and post deals out with your social network, Facebook and Twitter. We're going to have a lot more social networks coming up or social media networks coming up here in the end of the year. And just keep posted, like Instagram and so on. So just going to keep growing. So
fantastic. It's the beginning.
The beginning.
The very beginning. Yeah. But I got to tell you, I've been following you guys, quite some time now, and it's pretty amazing what you're doing. I think this could be really, really big. So people, check it out, hyperup.com. All right. Phone lines are open. 1-866-977-4820. 1-866-977-4820. I want to do a shout out to the Paleo Simplified crew that's listening to the radio show right now and maybe watching us on Facebook. You can go to News Talk Florida Facebook, right? So you can go to News Talk Florida Facebook and actually watch live. But the Paleo Simplified crew was in Hyde Park yesterday. At the Winn-Dixie in Hyde Park. The Winn-Dixie in Hyde Park carries the Paleo Simplified bars. You got to check it out. They're going to be carrying the Crunch. If not already, they will be carrying it soon. So go to paleosimplified.com. Learn about these paleo bars that we've been developing for many years now. But Winn-Dixie in Hyde Park has them. Also, Nature Food Patch over in Clearwater, they carry them in that bars section. I don't know how many they have. They've been selling very quickly, but they're delicious. Go by and buy some of those if you want a healthy snack. I mean, some people use it as a meal replacement as well. All right, we're going back to the phones. Steve in Tampa, good morning.
Morning, doctor. I have a blood pressure question on the... when it's borderline 80 over 140 active person, that's 45. I've heard a lot about it's a name brand, but the Super Beets. What do you think about these beet products that, raising the nitrogen and vasodilation and all that?
I love it as a natural approach, I got to tell you. As a matter of fact, this morning, Franz came over before the show, and we actually juiced some beets and the beet greens, some celery, an apple, some kale, and we had that right before we came to the show. So the good thing about beets...
There's my second part of my question. Does that help any because it's such a low concentration? Because I love beet juice.
Well, let me tell you this. I have actually had patients, and young and old, that have had elevated blood pressure. Here's an example. A good friend of the family, her blood pressure is 190 over 95. And her doctor gave her three prescriptions to lower her blood pressure. All right. Ouch. Three. She's 45 years old. Obviously stressed to do this. So I said, you know, start taking two of our Fortify Super Omega. Start juicing, you know, two beets twice a day. And I got to tell you, her blood pressure came down in 24 hours to 150 over 80, in 48 hours, 130 over 70, and it's remained that way for 2 months now. And she's juicing two beets a day and taking two Fortify Super Omegas. Now, obviously, you got to follow your doctor's advice. You know, she had this time. She didn't want to take the drugs. These were beta blockers and diuretics. Would have opened up a whole nother can of worms, possibly. So it does work. The whole theory behind beets, beets are very high in L-arginine. L-arginine is an amino acid that actually causes vasodilation. Also, it's very high in dietary nitrates, all right? And so it's a great post-recovery workout drink as well. You hear me talk about watermelon. Watermelon does a similar effect. Beets do as well. It's easier just to eat.
I like the watermelon. It's just too, I tend to get like a little yeast overgrowth sometimes. It's just too sweet for me, but right. I do love it, but it's just too sweet.
So
what I do is I put the celery in as a natural diuretic in with the beets.
Fantastic. That's a great way to go. You can add a little quarter of an apple too, just so you don't get too much sugar, but it makes it a little bit more palatable. But it's not that bad. I mean, regular beets taste pretty good when they're
juiced. Hey, doctor, there was a study, another subject. I was on another radio show a couple weeks ago that, how do they put it? If you exercise more, it actually causes heart disease and calcification in the arteries and so forth. Yeah, people that go to the extreme, and especially people that do the type of, what do they call it, the CrossFit and thing. And the only thing that I can add into that as to, you know, more is worse is, and I think you've seen this because you've probably been in the gyms like I have for 25 years. The people that do that, and God forgive me for saying this, but they seem to be a little more on the high stress side than the people that do more moderate exercise. And I think that may be painting that study.
Well, yeah, they're definitely a type A personality, no doubt. But, you know, everything in relative moderation, all right? So an Ironman competitor, I mean, that, you know, when you go and do something like that, it can break down muscles, okay? But that's a quest to do something like that. Triple Ironman, I mean, these people are amazing athletes, but a lot of these people are friends of mine, and as they get older, they develop some severe problems. I mean, especially arthritis, the impact on their joints from things like this. So, you know, as a rule of thumb, most of us aren't going to do an Ironman. Most of us not going to do a triple Ironman. So moderation, I think, is important. I've seen the same studies. But, you know, it also depends on what you're consuming. You know, if you're going into the gym, you should really consume a good pre-workout drink. And then afterwards, a good post-recovery drink. You know, do the things nutritionally. Because most of these people don't do this, and so
now you're doing a post of chocolate milk and watermelon. That's afterwards and protein, right?
Right. Scoop of the super protein, Fortify super protein, a big wedge of watermelon, and 2 cups of chocolate milk. And there's only 2 chocolate milks I recommend: either A2 chocolate milk or Promised Land chocolate milk. Both of those come from A2 cows. Stay away from the organic chocolate milk. Those are all have a genetically mutated A1, a beta casein, which is very bad. It can cause leaky gut, diabetes, cancer, kids, autism. So A2 cow's milk or Promised Land, either one.
Now on the pre-workout, I take a handful of, my wife gets me these little cans of macadamia nuts. They're like $3 for a tiny little can. But I will eat that entire can before a workout 2 or 3 times a week. What are you using?
Yeah, I mean, macadamia nuts are good in the good fats, the good oils. It's got a little bit of protein. It's fairly long-acting, medium-acting. But I do just I take white milk, you know, A2 cow's milk, because you need a little more protein. And I take another scoop of the protein, and then I use a low glycemic index, like maybe blueberries and a banana, not high glycemic index. So goat's milk is great.
You don't feel as though you need that fat. I think with me, for some reason, with my, you know, body type, I just happen to get that. I can't. In other words, if I eat a BLT, I feel like Superman.
Right.
I just seem to need a little fat of some sort.
Fat is very important.
Well, right?
Fat is very important. I always take an omega-3 with it. So omega-3 has the good essential fatty acids. So
why does a BLT sound better than a omega-3? You have a good day, doctor.
All right. Take care, Steve. Bye-bye. Steve's been a caller also. Very intelligent when it comes to nutrition. All right. You're listening to Ask the Doctor. I'm Dr. Michael Lange here with my welcome guest, Franz Leising, Vice President of Hyper Up. All right, we're going to go back to the phones. Let's go. We got another Steve. A lot of Steves out there today. Steve in Clearwater. Good morning.
A lot of us were born around 1955 to 1956 because there was a lot of famous Steves on TV. one thing I'd like to ask is, you know, you're talking about the beets. From what I understand, as a side comment, a lot of men have said that it has a Viagra-like effect from the vasodilation.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And another thing is, I always thought it was rather amusing. People talk about how good the dietary nitrates and nitrites are, but yet they say when, you know, nitrite is a food preservative, when they say they're in that, then they say dietary nitrates and nitrates aren't good for you. So it's kind of a catch-22.
Yep.
My main question is, wouldn't the sodium-potassium ratio in the vitreous humor affect how much macular edema could be? Because sodium tends to pull water in, it's extracellular, and it would pull water in, whereas potassium would prevent it from, it would actually push it out. And I was just wondering if the sodium potassium ratio would.
Yeah, that's a very valid question. Yeah, I mean, you must have a degree, or you're self-taught.
Totally self-taught. What happened is I don't even have a high school diploma. What happened is I had encephalitis in 1994, mm-hmm. and I've never made much more than minimum wage, and I said, you know something, if I can't afford to go to a doctor, I'm going to take 3 years and every day study everything about my encephalitis, and I started there, and I went from there, and I sort of self-educated myself. It's kind of like Abraham Lincoln.
Wow, fantastic. I got to commend
you. It's fun. When you learn it yourself, it's sort of selfish, because I say nothing stimulates medical scholarship more than personal morbidity.
That's absolutely correct. And that question, you know, these minerals and these electrolytes that are in the vitreous are all kind of in harmony. God put the eye together pretty well. They're all in harmony, and they're balanced very well, so that water's not coming in and water's not coming out. Now, you bring up a really neat point, because a lot of people would develop corneal problems, right? Corneal edematous conditions, swollen corneas related to aging and some other things. And we actually can buy over-the-counter something called Muro 128. It's sodium chloride, okay? Mm-hmm. And so if your cornea is swollen, we put sodium chloride eye drops in that causes the swelling to go down, causes less edema. But it's a much more difficult problem when you're actually in the eye. And when we develop swollen retinas, they're usually using steroidal and non-steroidal anti-inflammatories. We use those either topically, because there is some absorption back into the vitreous and into the retina, and then injectables, and also things like Posudex, which is actually an implantable pellet that has a time-release steroid that goes throughout the vitreous and into the retina. So there's a lot of ways to control swelling, but the key here, like I preach with Steve, the first caller, is to try not to let disease attack your body. And one of the best ways is preventatively, as you know, and that's practicing good nutritional habits, maintaining ideal weight, hydration with good water, fresh air, plenty of sleep, a little bit of sunshine, because sunshine is actually good in moderation. And a combination of all of these things is a very effective anti-aging tool.
Well, I think, like you say, a lot of people are dehydrated before they know they are.
Absolutely.
And one thing I thought was very interesting with dehydration is that thirst is actually two senses. There's osmotic thirst, which is the ratio of salts to water, and then there's volemic thirst, like you get if you're hemorrhaging.
You know,
so one's the volume of water, one's the ratio of water to salt, and they actually are two different senses, but you perceive them as one sensation. And but they're two different types. They're actually two different senses. It's very interesting.
That is pretty interesting. And you know, most people, like you said, are dehydrated here. There's some evidence that dehydration can cause heart palpitations, heart right. arrhythmias. And then you think about it, everybody listening has probably had two cups of coffee by now, all right? That's a diuretic, maybe three cups. And then tonight, what are they going to have? They're going to have their cocktail. They're going to have a couple of two, three beers or whiskey sours or wine. And so for every alcoholic beverage or coffee, you really need three cups of water to offset the diuresis effect. So now you think about it. They had three cups of coffee and three cocktails. So they need nine cups of water just to get back to homeostasis, and then half their body weight and ounces of water on top of that. So most of us are dehydrated. Now remember, if you overdrink water, you get into another condition that can be very dangerous because your mineral levels go down and you're saturated with water. So I always recommend, you know, especially athletes that are sweating and drinking tons of water, drink a little coconut water every now and then because that replenishes the electrolytes as well.
Well, one thing is that your sense of thirst, this is remarkable. Your eyes tend to start going in their 40s. Your hearing starts going in your 60s. Do you know when your sense of thirst starts going? It's shocking.
When?
When you're about 18 to 20 years old, your sense of thirst. Watch a bunch of children. After they've played basketball, they'll go up to a drinking fountain and gulp to gulp to gulp. You watch a bunch of 25-year-olds, just your sense of thirst starts to go in your 20s.
Interesting. Very interesting.
And I think the blood viscosity, you know how if you're cooking something with gravy and you add just one tablespoon of water, it makes the gravy a lot thinner?
Right.
Even you've only increased the volume of the gravy maybe 1% or 2%, but the viscosity of the gravy is massively changed. And so I think that the blood viscosity is an underutilized medical parameter in eye disease. I really think it is.
That's interesting. That's right. We don't want the blood.
I got to get off of here. All right. Nobody else will get on.
We don't want that blood getting thick and coagulating. Absolutely. You know, yeah, I learned something, and you open up my mind every time you call,
Steve. People confuse the clotting with the viscosity. You know, the viscosity is actually the thickness of the blood.
Right.
It has nothing to do with the clotting, and yet people, they think if they have their blood is viscous that they should take Coumadin. It has nothing to do with that. It's the ratio of water to solids.
Very interesting.
Okay, I got to go.
Thanks for the call, buddy.
God bless.
All right. Steve's been a good caller also. I tell you, he's got some tough questions. I mean, I think the guy is actually a PhD in biochemistry, self-taught. All right, phone lines are open. 1-866-977-4820. 1-866-977-4820. Remember, we've got a fall special for all of you that are taking the Fortify Super Protein and the Fortify Blue Green Superfood. Write this down. It's a promo code. You can use it on the website at fortify.com. It's basically fall 25. And when you buy one Fortify Super Protein, it can be the naked, the chocolate, or the vanilla, and one Blue Green Superfood, you get 25% off. So you can't beat that. That's the fall 25, and it's going to run till the end of the month. So go to fortify.com. That's F-O-R-T-I-F-E-Y-E, fortify.com. And then promo code at the end of checkout, the very end, there'll be a promo code, and you simply type in fall 25, and it'll automatically calculate 25%. I got to tell you, a lot of people are using this. I'm going to talk to Franz because he works out a lot. You've been taking the super protein, the superfood. You like the taste. You like the outcome.
Yeah, I love it. And I take it every time I work out. I work out five times a week and with you on the weekends. So I love it. Great results. I feel a lot better about it. And it just makes me feel stronger at the end.
Yeah, and you're making some really good gains. I mean, you guys see Franz is looking pretty good. And he's single. All you women out there. All right, phone lines are open, 1-866-977-4820, 1-866-977-4820. So talking about social media, you can follow me on, I think we got close to 70,000 people follow me on Twitter, Facebook, Google+, LinkedIn, Instagram. Instagram's been tough. I think I got close to 20,000 people on Instagram now, 20,000 people on LinkedIn. So that's a good way to stay in touch with what's going on in the eye care world and the nutritional world. And a lot of times, especially on my Twitter site, I'll give a special code that has some incredible discounts just for like 5 hours or 10 hours. So once again, follow me on Twitter. You can join and follow me if you simply go to our website, drmichaellange.com. DR and then michaellange.com. Don't spell out doctor, just drmichaellange.com. That'll link you up to all the other companies that I've developed. It'll also go to a section of social media where you can see all the different social medias and you can actually join them. Follow me on that. Also, I'm going to give you a YouTube channel. A lot of you have started to prescribe. This one's starting to grow, but it's Ocular Health. So go to YouTube and go to Ocular Health Channel. Go to YouTube, Ocular Health Channel. You can watch all of these videos from Ask the Doctor for years and years. But a lot of you enjoying some of the videos that we have for racing. As a matter of fact, HyperUp is the company that actually does a lot of these videos for me. And so Franz and his dad, Scott, are come out to the racetrack. They help me out. And they've done a really good job helping us out on these videos. So you can check that out. Some of these videos are really pretty cool of me racing in New Orleans and Miami at Sebring. So that's at Ocular Health Channel or just Ocular Health at YouTube. All right. So once again, before we go to any more calls, I want to talk again about, you know, businesses out there. I've been a business owner for years, and you're always thinking about ways to market your business. How can you get out there in front of the consumer? And there's a lot of ways out there, but there's a lot of ways that are crazy expensive. So the guys over at HyperUp are really pretty ingenious. They started thinking of ways of using social media to hype your company. And that's why it's called HyperUp. And it's been a long time coming. I mean, when did y'all start this, Franz?
It's been a couple of years now, so it's been a very long time, a lot of progress over the years now. We're finally at the end where, of course, there's always enhancements. We're always keep working. We work up until midnight, sometimes 3 o'clock in the morning. So we're always at the office, just enhancing the system, but it's been some long time now.
And you're using Facebook and Twitter right now.
Yeah, we're integrated with Facebook and Twitter, so you can sign up with Facebook and Twitter. Now, if you're a business, you do have to go through the regular business sign-ups process. Otherwise, you become a consumer, which that means you can go onto the site and just redeem deals. But if you're a business, click on the sign-in, sign-up button up top right on the page, and then it'll say business sign-up, and then just follow the steps. You can sign up free for a free account. You can have one deal that you can post out onto your social networks. It'll also be available on hyperup.com. And you can attach promo codes, whatever it may be for your deal. You can say 30% off on your products and it'll post out to your social networks. And the way it works is basically the business assigns a social requirement. So that could be like this deal or share this deal. And basically when a consumer goes on to that deal on hyperup.com that you've posted, you will be able to share your, or they will be able to share your deal out to all their followers and friends on Facebook. So basically the business is getting a huge viral marketing effect on that because it shares it out to all those people that are basically have all their friends out.
Right. So it's a great way that consumers can go to hyperup.com and see how they can save some dramatic savings without paying a dime, really, right?
Yes.
And that's another way that businesses can actually market to consumers.
Yes.
All right. Well, thanks for being a guest and talking a little bit about that. We're going to hear a lot more about this. I mean, who knows? It might be a $1 billion IPO in the near future. You never know. So check it out. That's called hyperup.com. All right. Let's open up the phone lines again. If you got a question regarding your vision and eye care, 1-866-977-4820. That's 1-866-977-4820. Remember, we're going to have a fall bash. We've been doing this for 10 years now, a fall bash at the Lange Eye Institute in the Villages sometime in November, probably in the middle of end of November. Who knows if it's not early December. We're still figuring out if we're going to put it on a weekday or the weekend. And if you listeners want to chime in, let me know if it'd be better to be like on a weekday or a Saturday after the radio show. And we are going to figure out what we're going to have, if it's going to be a Western, if it's going to be a 50s, you know, what is it going to be? What type of wardrobe? But usually we have a lot of fun. We have music, we have food, and a lot of great deals. Also, just remember, Paleo Simplified Bars, the Winn-Dixie in Hyde Park. That's a great Winn-Dixie. It's an atypical Winn-Dixie. This place is amazing. Go by, check it out. Paleo Simplified has three different flavors. These are low index, low glycemic index, pure paleo, no binders or fillers that are bad for you, all gluten-free, all organically grown nutrients are in it. I would not have anything with endorsing anything if it's not good for you. I take it. My children take it. My parents take it. Also, you can buy that on Amazon. I mean, you can get it off the fortify.com website. You can go to paleosimplified.com. So there's a numerous ways you can buy it. Winn-Dixie, Nature Food Patch in Clearwater, Winn-Dixie in Hyde Park. Plus, there's a lot of other places, you know, Whole Foods and Fresh Markets and things like this that carry Paleo Simplified. Remember the Fall 25 promo code. A lot of you have been taking advantage of this. I started promoting it last week. Fall 25, when you buy the Fortify Super Protein and the Blue Green, Organic Blue Green Superfood, put the promo code Fall 25 and you get 25% off. So I got to just toot my horn a little bit. When I develop something, when I develop a supplement, I research, and research it. I develop it, redevelop it, and redevelop it until I like it. And I was not satisfied with the proteins that are on the market. The majority of proteins that you have, people don't realize, first of all, the cheese is where this comes from, this whey protein. That cheese has been dyed. So then they have to use a bleach to get the dye out to make the protein white. So that's two things that have been done to adulterate the protein. They dyed it and then they bleached it. And most of this protein is coming from cows that are fed synthetic hormones to increase milk production, fed antibiotics because they're in these feedlots, they're not grass-fed and they have lots of disease, and fed all sorts of other types of steroids. And when they do let them out in the grass, it's grass that has lots of pesticides on it, and all of this goes into the milk. And so, once again, when I'm talking about drinking milk, drink A2 cow's milk. Please give that to your children. Goat's milk or A2 cow's milk. You can't go wrong. And it has protein in it. There's nothing wrong with coconut milk and hemp milk and almond milk, but that doesn't have much protein, okay? So I developed a protein that is not bleached. It comes from A2 cows. It comes from New Zealand year-round grass cows. It's a concentrate, not an isolate. A lot of you that are bodybuilders are thinking, oh, you got to have the isolate. Well, the isolate has no fat in it, and fat is good as long as it's good fat. So that's why the concentrate is important, because it stimulates your immune system. All of the immunoglobulins are in it, the lactoferrin, the CLA, the covalent bonded cysteine. So not only is it going to your muscle very quickly, increasing strength and muscle and losing fat, but it's kickstarting your immune system. Drinking a whey protein concentrate is the best way, a grass-fed whey protein concentrate, the best way to stimulate glutathione, which is the master antioxidant in your body. Think about it. You're 45, 55, 65, 75 years of age now, especially a man, and the doctor's telling you got low testosterone and wanting to put you on T, and then you got to take other medications because your estrogen levels are going up. Well, try a whey protein concentrate. Make a smoothie, drink it once or twice a day, and give it about 2 to 3 months. You'd be amazed. It kickstarts your immune system. It makes you feel better. When glutathione levels go up, you feel a lot better. Add a little watermelon or add beet juice. And once again, the beet juice helps circulation to every part of your body, every part of your body. And it helps with muscle growth as well. That's why I want you to do beet juice or watermelon right after working out. So that's why I developed the whey protein concentrate, to have something legitimately that's going to benefit you. Now, the superfood. When you go to the market and you buy a blue-green superfood or a greens powdered food, half of the powder that's in there is a fiber, half of it. Look at the back of your superfood or your greens formula right now. It's got acacia fiber, flaxseed fiber, oat fiber, bran fiber. And then they're making you think, oh, that's important. You got to have this fiber because it's great for your, you know, your colon and your, you know, everything like that, your digestive system. But they fail to tell you soluble and insoluble fiber used at the same time with these other antioxidants blocks the absorption of a good portion of the antioxidant profile. So you're not getting the health benefits. So I developed a blue-green superfood that doesn't have any added fiber at all. And we're using 1,000 milligrams of blue-green algae, which is spirulina, 1,000 milligrams of blueberries. We're using 500 milligrams of wheatgrass juice, not just wheatgrass, barley grass juice. This is super concentrated. All of it's organic. It's gluten-free. Blueberries, strawberries, cranberries, celery, spinach, kale, all the things that are good for you, but they're also FODMAP-free. That doesn't mean a lot to you. FODMAP-free means it's not going to cause fermentation in your gut and bloating. Think of it, you men and women out there, after you eat and you feel bloated. Well, you're having a reaction to the fruits and vegetables, and your primary care physician doesn't have a clue what that means usually. FODMAPs, Google that, F-O-D-M-A-P. And you'll find out that the broccoli, the cherries, the cauliflower, the cabbage that you're eating. Now, everybody doesn't have a reaction to it. Those are very good vegetables. But a lot of you are getting bloating and irritable bowel syndrome symptoms just from these foods that you're eating. As a matter of fact, there is a food sensitivity called HemaCode. We're going to talk a lot more coming down the pike. There is a way you can test for food sensitivities that you'll be able to purchase over the counter. Not over the counter, but over an internet very soon. As a matter of fact, I'm going to expand on it next week. Where you do a little sample of your blood, and it will tell you what you have food sensitivities to. It's going to be much more cost effective than a lot of the things that are coming through your physician's office right now. All right. Let's open up the phone lines. We do have calls. Time for a call. I know I was rambling on there, so a couple of people got tired of holding. But give me a call. If you're in my listening audience, 97.3 FM, The Sky, 8:20 AM from, Tallahassee over to Pensacola, all the way down to Keys, up to Macon, Georgia. You can hear my voice, 1-866-977-4820. Give me a call, 1-866-977-4820. All right, we're going to go back to talking to Franz really quick. Now you have another job, don't you?
I do.
So you're working like a dog. So you work probably 8 hours a day banking.
Yep.
And then you work another 8 hours in the evening on Hyper Up.
Yeah, and I fit the gym schedule in there as well, right between.
Well, it's very important to eat well, to exercise. You got to find the time. So like I said earlier in the show, you work 16 hours a day, 6-7 days a week. You're going to be successful. So I see you ringing the bell soon at stock market on Wall Street. One more time, let our listeners know where they can go to learn more about this.
Yeah, just go to www.hyperup.com. There's some welcome pages on there on the right-hand side where you can see what the consumer can get out of the site and then what the business can get out of the site. Sign up if you're a business, you get a free account, you can publish your deals on there and let the consumers do these advertising for you, basically. Consumers, the audience out there, they get great deals. We're probably going to put some of your products on there. They're already on there as well, and especially this one that we're talking about, the paleo bars. I'll put that on there today, and they can go on there as well and get that code and use it. But yeah. Go on there, check it out, see Hype on there.
Yeah, so Hype is your animated kind of cartoon-looking guy that has been brought to life.
Yes.
I mean, he's bending, his mouth is working. I mean, it's really pretty cool. I mean, it's amazing what technology can do now to animate things.
It is. I mean, he's a character, that's for sure.
I still think you should have used my voice, but... All right. I got to talk about something here. Last week we talked about dry eye, and I got to tell you, I had numerous emails. I mean, I must have had 25, 26 emails wanting to know more about natural approach to treating dry eye. First of all, I'm going to give everybody my email address. This is the new email address. Don't use my AOL account anymore. There's something up with AOL. They're wanting me to change my password every other day. So go to idude92@icloud.com. idude92@icloud.com. That's EYEDUDE 92@icloud.com. Also, while you got your pen and paper, I'm going to give you the phone number for the Lange Eye Institute. I'm also going to give you the phone number for 4 to 5 vitamins. So the phone number for the Lange Eye Institute, if you'd like to see any of our doctors, ophthalmologists, optometrists, optometric physicians, any of us, you can call 352-753-4014. Lange Eye Institute, remember, we take Medicare, we take most insurances, we take the United Healthcare HMO that's in the villages. Phone number for an appointment, 753-4014, area code 352-753-4014. Also, we have a huge optical and amazing display of frames. We got some really high-end frames, things like LaFont that are handmade, and we have some very economical frames, and we do price match as well. Also, we have a huge contact lens inventory. We are contact lens specialists. We do scleral contact lens fits, synergize. We do keratoconic fits. We do routine one-day disposables as well. And then the phone number for 4 to 5 vitamins. If you'd like to get anything I talk about in this program, if you want to call and talk to my very educated staff at 4 to 5 vitamins, you can call 1-866-503-9746. 1-866-503-9746. Also, I'm going to talk relatively quickly here. I want to tell you the natural approach for dry eyes, all right? Because this was big last time. Remember, if your eyes feel sandy, gritty, burn, tear, itch, fluctuation in vision, we're all plagued with these symptoms. Chances are your eyes are dry. As we get older, our eyes get drier. Medications dry our eyes out. Certain job applications, over-the-counter, over-the-road drivers, computer workers, people under a ceiling fan, air-conditioned environments, all dries your eyes out even further. Many diseases cause the eyes to dry out as well. So what do? We do five things. We heat the lids, we clean the lids, we neutrify the glands, we lubricate the eye, and we hydrate, okay? So hydration is very important. We talked about that today. Drinking good spring water, some coconut water every now and then. If you buy bottled water, make sure it says spring water on it. Do not buy purified water. We heat the lids, so hot compresses a few times a day, or buy the brooder mask you put in the microwave. It Velcros around your eyes. Do it a couple of times, 5-10 minutes a day. Hydration of the eye, lubricating the eye. I like Oasis Tears Plus, or Blink Tears the best for that. And the neutrification of the glands. Fortify Super Omega, 2 per day, and 1 Fortify Focus a day. That's a combination that brings the nutrients to the glands so you secrete a healthier tear film. You can go to fortify.com and go under the dry eye section. You'll see dry eye kits that I've developed. Extreme dry eye kits and regular dry eye kits. The extreme dry eye kits have everything all in one kit for about a 40% discount. All right, I'm out of here. Franz, thanks for being a guest on Ask the Doctor.
Thank you for having me.
And have a great day. God bless you.